Okay, so I've made an asteroid cutter on a base. It's a lot of weight holding by two legs. So I wonder if I should. So there's no rotation on that bit, so I should probably put an extra couple of legs here for parking. So yes, big storage, probably should put a refinery in, need to connect that up actually. So asteroid cutter, what could possibly go wrong? I put pistons to point to drill forward, and I put sideways ones to just hack in sideways. The idea is to drill through an asteroid using a base. Right, there's a pivot and there's a pivot. That's probably going to snap off, I imagine. Well, let's switch it on. It'll probably shake itself to pieces. I'm not sure it's got enough power at the moment. Thrusters. Don't need any thrusters. Power usage. I'm going to put some more power in because I know I'm going to need more power. And I want to feed the big dinghies. So, conveyor tube, so there we go, and now some power modules and more gyros, because the biggest fear I've got is it will shake itself apart. So put the gyros here and then power, although to be honest I imagine the forces are going to snap those pivots off, but we can try. Right, so, moment of truth, save it again. I imagine something horrible's going to happen. Right, so, is it I or something for inventory? Drills, let's group them up. It's a lot of drills. Next step, if I can actually get it to work, is to try and figure out how to do it cheaply rather than horrendously expensive. Good grief. I think I might have overdone the drills a bit. Might cause it to crash. Oh, come on. I'm pretty sure I can use shift, but I'm not going to mess it up. Just using control select. There we go. 80 drills. Let's call that drills. one. Odd. Oh dear, that looks all... This one needs loads and loads of gyros, look at it, just wobbling all over. That's nice and stable though on the left. Let's have a look. They're nice and stable. They're not nice and stable. So, gyro time. I need to figure out some sort of feed as well, which is really tricky for them. Yes, I imagine this is the thing of weakness. Stop jerking off. Better. A bit worried about putting them on the actual pistons. Right. I mean, I will put them on the pistons if I have to. Right, that's a bit better, it's a bit more solid, although as soon as those pistons... Right, a note about pistons, don't switch them all on at the same time. Right, well, this is purely a pistons and sideways thing, so let's get on the machine. So this is the space-based controller. Got to be a less resource-heavy way of doing this. Anyway, the idea of this is just to cut through them, the asteroid. Right, so keep it at 3 p.m. Imagine that's going to cause some snappage. There we go. That's doing the cutting. So I've set it at 3, I'm not going any deeper than that. Let's have a look. Is it moving? Yes. Those pivots don't look very secure to me. So, just had to terraform a asteroid. Carve out a great chunk and drill a hole in it. I wonder what's going to happen when it contacts. So I need to stick some refinery in there or something so I can take the ore and just start refining it. Maybe I'll stick a few more storage containers in. As long as it doesn't stick its head above the let's do all that later. Right. Like I said, I could put an extra couple of legs here. Attached to the same platform. Might help with stability. So, what do we think? Do you think it's going to work? Do you think I need less drills. That's a space base with two rotors and two pistons, little platform with five pistons I think, for drilling. Here we go. Wonder if I should have had... Good. So yeah, why did I do this? Just to see, I think I've not angled that properly. Okay, I'm going to do one sweep of it. Not sure I want to go in reverse. But I'm just thinking that I should really have one more... I should really have one more layer of drills just to cover myself for the shake, because I don't want the shake to destroy things. Can you hear something go... Oh, I think that drill's going in the middle. Okay, pretty sweet for a hangar. I need to smooth it all out a bit, and I've got one piston connected to the main body, the first one. So when it's free, I'm going to fire up that first piston and push it all forward one. Give me a bit more depth. Plus, I've got these two pistons as well. Always seem to need more depth. But that's a good first swing. Whilst it's... Is it still moving? Is it caught on anything? It's still moving. Right, so when it's free, let's get in the cockpit of the base of the station. I've got two pistons. It's not the first one, it's the second one. Ooh, don't want to get that one particularly. Right, there's a spin. I might stop the spin when it's out. No, I'm not going to stop the spin. So, what I've put is the increased velocity on the rotors and the reverse command for the pistons. I'll be free yet. I need a camera up there somewhere so I can monitor it. I'm free. Hit reverse just to slow it. Oh. I want it to be fast. Now, let's go and have a look. If I've got two pistons, frame off, am I? Right, I've got that piston and that piston. I think I can do it. I'm gonna get this wrong. One piston. Because the whole thing's moving. So I was all worried when it fully extends so it doesn't snap off. Right, let's have a look. Second sweep now. So I've double extended that, plus that. Asteroid doesn't look too happy, does he? So yes, if I did it again, I think I would put an extra, I want one extra top and bottom of the drills just to give a bit more clearance. I could speed it up to 6 RPM, but I'm really concerned that those pistons will just break. the next thing to do once I've gone through it as deep as I can on the sides is to try this drill just to punch further through. I'm not sure about the drill. The idea is to drill a hole into the middle, but, or a tunnel, an access tunnel through the back. Let's have a look what's in these. So we just filled in one container so far. So the great thing about this is that you can do it AFK, although to begin with obviously I want to make sure it doesn't blow up. So let's see what it's like going through it. Probably need an obs deck somewhere or a camera. Gyros there. What's this? That's the support beam at the bottom. Do an inspection afterwards. Oh, what's this? That's not good. I'm surprised these are drilling something, considering how far back they were. It looks like that could do a bit closer, couldn't it? Yeah, because you can always, with the pivots, you can always build the drills out here pointing out, so then they spin in. So the base, if I do it again, I do it much closer. And the base has a gravity generator on it and some stairs. What's going on here then? Oh yeah, you don't want to cut it completely in half. You need some structural integrity, although a hole through the middle would be nice. But I'm a bit concerned that some of the gyros came off. Right, yeah, because the support struts going underneath, they have to be within this limit and they have to be free of the drill so they don't get pivot destroyed. quite like some way of hollowing it out. And with this thing, of course, you can increase the pivots. So I can do this piston and it all goes up one, which I think I'll do as soon as it's free. Right, a bit of damage done there. This frame's alright. Don't want to mess with that. Something got a bit knackered there. I don't know why. Bit of shape. Do with a display, so 5 or 6. There we go, 6. Wonder if I have to reel in my neck. Probably do actually. So I've reeled in 5, which is that. So that one's reeled in, and that one isn't. And I better reel this one in as well, number 2. Still haven't used the drill bit, and having thought about it, I think I've got a rotor on the base as well, so I can actually chop it. It's not just horizontal, I can actually twist that. Well, fortunately, I think I could quite easily just chop my whole base into pieces if I wasn't careful. So yeah, I've got one rotor here for the spin, and then I've got, have I got another for vertical? I think that's a rotor there, isn't it? Yeah, so that could go vertical instead of horizontal. If I'm going to do that, I've got to make sure I don't chop my base into pieces. Shall we try a little bit faster? This could destroy my whole thing. spin it round faster. Might snap it off. Guess I need to stress test. Oh, that looks like that could have disconnected there. No. I did put a pivot on this thing, but then I got it confused with the others. I don't want to hit the rock at 18. I imagine it's all going to fall to pieces. Let's just save it. Actually, I'm not going to save it. I think it might have gone too far for saving. Hit them by mistake. 30, as fast as it will go. It's going at 30, it still looks slow to me. Was it stopped? I think I've snapped something. No. I was happy at 3, I was not so happy at 30, I think. What have I snapped? Oh no, is it moving? You look alright? Well, there's one way to tell. Considering I changed it to minus 30, I would have thought it would be a bit quicker than that. I wonder if there's some way to stop the piston in the middle. Okay, I'm going at 9 RPM. That might, allegedly. Thinking about it, I don't know if this is going to leave it too exposed. I quite like having, especially for meteor showers and things, you only want a small entrance really. It's interesting to see the core of it, isn't it? quite a good specialist bit of kit. Is try and drill a punch a hole through there. Ready. Next bit will be to try and get the drill to work, which I think will be another video.